cost, and we elected to defer our choice the second half, and put us on defense first game. What we want. And what we've got to come out and do is control the line of scrimmage. Be alert. Be thinking outside beer, first play. They'll throw a little bit. Pre-game, they were throwing a lot from the slot side. Down and out, short out with the slot. Eric, you've got to really read the release of the slot back. So that if it's pass, you're out underneath that thing in a hurry. You can't be caught up inside, giving him a free lane to throw through outside. As you're looking in there, when you see that, you'll feel it. Get out there and get underneath it.
Schulte, if we're going to strength, 44 may or may not be that guy. We assume he will be. He may end up in the backfield with that razzle-dazzle crap. Okay, if he's in the backfield, you know he's getting the ball, and he may throw it. So just be aware of who's where.
Right, we get you a strength call. Right away, look to where the width of the field is at. When they break the huddle, there's even that much confusion, you call white side. Right? You call white side. There. They did run a little cross buck out of the eye we haven't shown you, and we've seen it before. We didn't take any time to practice it. It's just a trap scheme, double team, guard pull, pull back one way, tail back the other. It's really nothing new we haven't practiced against before. Just really get after it physically to start the football game. Make sure that they are not allowed to think that, hey, we have a chance. Can't allow them to think that. And we get the ball. I really think this game will be won up front on offense. If you guys up front can control the line of scrimmage, control the gaps, and allow us to move the ball and have ball control, we're going to be in great shape. I'm firmly convinced we'll play a great defensive game tonight. We have to move the ball offensively and not allow them to get some big plays and get all cranked up because they shot the A gap and they were all excited. You know, let's just look at what is at stake here. A sixth straight spot in the playoffs, a district championship, a chance to come back next Wednesday night and play in front of a big crowd, a team that we've never played before. You know, as coaches, some of our best memories here are what some of the things that have happened to us in the playoffs over the years. You guys have the right to experience that. You have brought yourselves back into a position that we asked you to do after week three was just let's go out, win them all, give ourselves a chance to get in the playoffs at the end of the year. Put ourselves in that big game where if we win, we're in. That's exactly what we have done. But like we said in the other room, there's some unfinished business. And if you think of the alternatives of walking off that field tonight with your head down for the last time ever, never putting these pads on again, there is no choice. Now let's get out there and go.
Yeah!
One in a row, fellas! One in a row!
Now the other halfback, number 44, Trevor Abraham, 165 pounds. Fullback for the Tigers, number 29, Brandon Hill, 170 pounds. And quarterback for the Tigers, number 165 pounds.
time.
Punch count.
Punch count.
Punch count.
Punch. Punch.
Ball goes out of bounds on the 32 yard line.
Yeah!
Yeah!
there's any question in your mind if they came to play or not, I hope it's answered. You know how safe a 7-point lead is against this football team. It's not at all. Might as well be tied. We get the ball down in there and we hold. We get the ball down in there and we jump off sides or go in motion or procedure. We get the ball down in there and we hold again. You know how sick I am of holding calls? I mean, it's the ninth game of the year. And we're grabbing claws where we don't need to be. We've mistaked them right into this game. And if you think you're not in for a hell of a second half, you better strap her up. We cannot afford one more mistake. Not one. If we hope to win this football game. And we better come out and play hard. Now, we're on defense. We're doing a pretty good job. We got that outside bear figured out. You know what's going on when it comes to you now?
Yeah.
What's the slot doing?
Well, he's just slowing down. And
should take you right to the mesh.
The last two times you haven't even given the guy a ride. Just keep him going.
All right. Well, then you're reading it okay. I don't think it's a read here. I think it's a predetermined. It's a predetermined give or keep. That shouldn't give us any problems. What they'll go back to is the crack, is the keep. They'll crack down on you, try to get him to the outside. Are you linebackers able to get in the flow of that play? Okay, listen up. Now, Pat, we've done a nice job on pass rush. We've gotten to him a couple times. But stay in your lane. You've got to be very disciplined on the pass rush. We can get to him.
My trips, when it's trips, I'm on the weak side. You want me to rush? But one time, they do that with trips for that screen.
Was that correct? Back to you?
Yeah. Should have been screened in there.
Well, you were definitely in the right spot, but I hate to only rush three guys. Did you feel it? Was it to the tight end or the back?
To the tight end.
So, I mean, you can feel it coming. Well, if you can play it like that, that's fine. But otherwise, you got to be going or trip to that side. Offensively, in the 400 set, the 35 and 36 they have in the spot, man, we must have 200-300 yards of total offense. We've got 7 points. That's the problem. We've got to get some points on the board. You can't sit on 7 points. They're going to score and go for two the first time they score. Now all of a sudden we're behind catching up. That's what we've got to avoid. That's why we've got to get on the scoreboard first in the second half. We've got to receive the ball, we've got to take it down, and we've got to score. You have left yourself no margin for error now. All right? That's what makes the job difficult. But we know we've been controlling the football game. But you just can't allow them a chance. Once we get two touchdowns up on them, then we've got control of them. Because they're not moving it in spurts where they can hope to score like that. Then they got to start and do goofy stuff and gamble. But we cannot feel comfortable with that 7-point lead. We have got to come out and really gear it up third quarter. I mean really gear it up. Like we're a football team that's got something to play for here. No more mistakes. Nothing but great football plays. All right? We cannot have anything more like happened out there in the first half. We did a lot of good things, and every good thing we did, we offset it with a negative. The good football teams do not do that. They keep piling up the good things, and pretty soon it wears your opponent down and it crushes their spirit. All we keep doing is they're hanging by their fingernails, and we're ready to put the thumb on the throat, and we give them a chance to climb back up the ladder. Man, we had them buried if we go in and score. Now, this is what we've got to come back out third quarter and do. And put them right back in that hole, and they will quit. You cannot leave any daylight at the end of the tunnel for them. Now, when we went into trips and we ran speed options, they really slid secondary over, didn't they? You know, who was the tight end in there on that play? What was back on your side? Did you happen to look?
He was still just outside of me.
Where was it? Was there a defensive end to your outside?
He was down on me.
I don't think so.
I mean, we can come back to the weak side. If they're going to shift everybody over that far, we've got to come back with some weak side plays. We can run trips right 36. We can come back trips right. We can dive the ball. And we could run the quick out to the tight end. Because I don't think he's right up on you, is he?
No.
All right.
The middle's up to two.
Who's got to take the play?
Have they looped him the same way every time?
The end, or like the down end.
He shoots down on his hands and knees.
He's going like this.
Linebacker is shooting outside, so they're just
on my side.
They're just doing a little X out.
Are you getting a block?
The outside play.
Yeah.
Because I go down the block and you can see it.
Normally, the game is on the back side.
So what happens if we go 400 set and crack back on that flex back?
We'll never get to him. Is he coming out that wide?
He's going way out.
He's an upfield player, though, isn't he?
He's going way out.
He's the contained man.
All right.
Well, maybe we can get a shot at that back 5-6 yards or three yards.
Split down a little bit.
See if we can
nail it. Now, it seems like on our TO calls, the 234 TO down close to the field, but we're getting the give read, but after he gets it, there's nothing there. You know? Why are we not making any blocks out of you interior people on those TO calls? I mean, do you remember any of them? Because we came in there with 33 TO one time, and I can see why we get close. You get your head and shoulders down backs and get the first down. Then take what's left. But don't spin yourself out of a first down. You were there. You were there, and you took yourself right out of it. Okay, now, we got a couple quarters to play, and she's all on the line for you now. We had better get her geared up, go out, catch the kickoff, take it back up the field, and we've got to score on this one, all right?
Steve! down, sir.
Good job, boy!
No, I've got first down!
Come on!
Take it down, let's go!
Hey,
Thunder.
Got Brandon to fill up and carry on.
Come on!
Yeah.
Eat it! Come on!
24
right there! Yeah, keep your mouth shut, alright?
One left! One left! One left!
No!
single quick.
Get the first down.
Need three. 2-3 out.
6:30 speed up.
Number 35, Ira Johnson.
Oh yeah! How's it feel, boys? District champs, man.
All right, come in here, folks. Let's go. Come on in here.
Yeah!
Yeah! Now, wait. When we get inside, we got a lot to talk about, so I want you to go in and sit down. You sophomores need to help us clear the sideline. How's it feel, big district champs?
Yeah!
We're going to have one good Spencer, and then we're going in. All right, everybody in here, let's go. You ready?
Go.
For you guys that are not going to be carried on a playoff roster, you'll turn your gear in Monday. For everybody else, we're going to meet at 10 o'clock. All right, that first one will just be lifting and looking at this film. We'll do some easy running, and then we'll come back in the afternoon. We'll have to go out and practice. You know, it'll be light, but we've got to get started. The teams that advance in these playoffs are the ones that can get back to work right away the next day. That's what we have to do tomorrow. Proud as heck of you, did a great job. Glad for the win. I think we can go a long ways in these playoffs, fellas, and that's why I told you.
Yeah!